Good evening and welcome to this streaming concert with works dedicated to the recorder and works by Jacob van Eyck, 17th century Dutch composer, contemporary of Rembrandt. I will be playing many different recorders and I will maybe talk later a little bit more about my instruments and about Jacob van Eyck. So enjoy.
Thank you.
those were the first portion of works by Jacob van Eyck. Jacob van Eyck's Der Fluiten Lusthof, published in the middle of the 17th century, contains kind of tunes, popular tunes from that time, and variations on those tunes. And those tunes come really from all over Europe. So the last piece you heard is called A Scottish Song. So I took that as an inspiration to push it a bit further. But the next song is called Come Again by John Dowland, on which Jacob van Eyck made variations. So in many ways, you can see it as a jukebox to the 17th century. We have many, many paintings still from the 17th century, Rembrandt being and Vermeer being very famous for it, and Holland very famous for it. But unfortunately, we do not have a lot of music from that time. So this is, one of the few collections of music that we have from that time, which allow us to get a glimpse of the soundtrack of the 17th century. It is hard to imagine now, as the recorder is probably the most hated instrument in the world, but in the 17th century, the recorder was very, very beloved and was really played by many, many people. It features on many paintings in the 17th century, and it was played by women and men, high class, low class, and the huge collection of tunes by Jacob van Eyck is, we can see that it was really very, very popular. I will continue now with variations by Jacob van Eyck on the song Come Again by John Dowland. That was Come Again, Variations by Jacob van Eyck. The books are almost falling apart. I have played this music since I was 10 years old, and I haven't really changed the book, so it doesn't look so glamorous anymore, but I think you can see the time passing on the books themselves. That is also the strength of Jacob van Eyck's music, that the simple themes can be played from a beginner's level, and then it gets more and more complicated the quicker the variations go. Maybe I can take a little bit of time to speak a little bit about the kind of instruments that I'm using for this recital. So this is the instrument which resembles mostly what people know as a recorder. It is a so-called Baroque recorder in three parts. This particular one is in G and made by Ernst Mayr, the late Ernst Mayr. And that is the model is like that the bore shape becomes smaller towards the end, as you can see. But I'm also using many so-called Ganassi recorders, which if you compare, well, maybe I should just, you can really see how they differ in the bore shape. The Ganassi recorders are a kind of copy after Renaissance instruments, and I think they suit the music of Van Eyck very well. I have them in different lengths, which means that they come also in different pitches. So there's a bass in G, a tenor in C, an F in G, yeah, basically the whole gamut of possibilities is there. The Ganassi instruments are made by Monika Musch from Freiburg, and later I will play those two tiny instruments. They're made by Tom de Vries, a Dutch builder, actually a Frisian builder. This is a not unimportant detail for me. Okay, I will continue with L'Entrelu.
Thank you.
Van Eyck not only wrote variations on popular themes, but also on music from the church. So I will now play variations on Psalm 118. Thank you. in some way or another, playing the recorder solo seems to be a very appropriate business during Corona times. Playing alone or being alone, just more generally, philosophically, it forces you to reflect. And playing alone or recording yourself and then listening back is a kind of, it's an interesting journey, I think. And I think this Corona time is interesting, to say the least, for many people around the world, for some also very bad and terrible. But the introspective part, I think, is quite good about it. I will continue now with variations on Blijdschap van mijn Vliet.
Thank you.
We have come to the last piece of this recital already. And this piece is called Wat zal men op den avond doen? What shall we do this evening? And it was a piece that was always played as a kind of bell for the last round. So it's an appropriate last piece. Maybe a little bit more about Jacob van Eyck. He was blind, and if you were blind in the 17th century, there were not that many job options. But like Stevie Wonder, he went into music, and he had someone else write down all of his improvisation compositions, and that's why we have them now, and that's why we can enjoy them now. I want to also take this opportunity to thank the people from the Amarta Foundation and this amazing venue here where I am able to bring you this music. So yes, it feels a bit weird sending this out into cyberspace, but I hope you had a great time and enjoy the last piece. And do let me know in the feed some comments or whatever you want to share, hopefully positive. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you very much for your virtual applause. Bye-bye.